Spoilers ahead for Lobotomy Corporation, Library of Ruina, Leviathan, Distortion Detective, and Wonder Lab. So, Limbus Company released at the end of last month, and something I noticed was that a lot of players, particularly new players to the series, basically had no idea what was going on. So, whether you're a new player who's fresh to the series, or a returning player who's trying to read up on the lore...
I remember. I'm illiterate.
I can assure you that after this, you still won't know what's going on. But you will occasionally be able to do that Captain America meme. So, first things first, let's establish a timeline. Limbus Company is the third game in the series, both chronologically and in release order, and as such features many things from the previous games that new players won't be aware of. So, let's head back to the first game, Lobotomy Corporation. Don't worry if I say any terms that you don't recognize or understand, I'll get to them later. Now, in Lobotomy Corporation, you play as Manager X, who works for, you guessed it, Lobotomy Corporation, who tasked you with juicing an increasing number of monsters called abnormalities pharyngi, in the form of enkephalin, over the course of 50 days. Now, while this is occurring, the events of Wonder Labs is playing out, a comic which basically follows the employees of a different branch of Lobotomy Corporation, also juicing away at those succulent abnormalities. God, why do I say it like that? Both of these come to a conclusion right before the Dark Days and White Nights event, which I believe lasted for 7 days before immediately leading us into the next game in the timeline, Library of Ruina. So, what exactly were the Dark Days and White Nights? Well, remember all that juicing Mandrax did? As it turns out, he was also building a juice cannon, which he proceeded to use to shoot it all directly into the sky for 7 entire days. Now, unfortunately, a bit of a mutiny occurred, and it was cut short to 3, and whilst Major X got his happy ending, being raptured into the light, Angela, the lovable and totally legal AI, decided she wanted a sequel. Now, in this game, you follow a guy who enters the library, literally what the location is called, without his library card. Delimbed and then relimbed, he is forced by the head librarian to kill anyone and everyone who enters her library for that
knowledge. In fact, I'm a lot more proud of these 7 new bookshelves that I had to get installed to hold 2,000 new books that I bought.
Turning them into books in the process. During this, the events of Distortion Detective play out. Unfortunately, it's a book and reading is hard. Anyways, the library continues to do its thing until the government, known as the Head, gets sick of their shit and teleports the entire thing into the wastelands known as the Outskirts. Good riddance. However, right before they do, she releases all the people they brutally murdered, returning them alive and well in human form back to the city. So then Leviathan starts, and it turns out that wasn't such a great idea. Goodbye, orphans! Here we follow the antics of the Red Gaze, as he tries to move on from Lovetown and keep the last 2 surviving orphans alive. Oops. Anyways, here we are at our destination at last, Limbus Company. And that's pretty much it so far. Now let's head over to the setting of the series. All 3 games take place in the city. The city is, as far as we're aware, the last remaining human civilization anywhere. It's roughly the size of a small country and houses approximately 7 billion humans. The city is split into 26 districts, labeled A through to Z, and in each one there is a Nest and the Backstreets. The Nest, for all intents and purposes, is the rich people place, and the Backstreets are for the peasants. The Backstreets connect all of the districts together, whereas the Nests are more isolated within the Backstreets. The city is run by the Head, which consists of districts A through to C. If there's anything you need to know about the Head, it's that if they've taken notice of you, you've made a grave error. From what we know, they have arbiters from A Corp, beholders from B Corp, and claws from C Corp. They have plenty of rules, but the most important ones are to pay your taxes, be a human, and don't break the other rules. The remaining districts are run by wings, essentially massive corporations, and what they say goes, so long as it doesn't contradict the Head. Now, each wing possesses at least one singularity of their own, which is an incredibly advanced technology of some sort, and how it works is heavily guarded by said wing. However, should the wing ever fall, and fall they do, the singularity becomes available for everyone and anyone to use, so long as they can figure out how to use it. One such instance of this was the Smoke War, where several wings took each other on and eventually resulted in the old Elk Corp falling and being replaced by the Lobotomy Corporation we know and love from the first game. As far as it matters for this video, when I say corporation, it's interchangeable with wing. So, returning to singularities, one of the more prominent ones in the series is Lobotomy Corporations, which was the ability to manifest the human psyche in a physical form. From there, they devised a way to get them to produce a drug called enkephalin, which was used as a power source throughout the city. Now, these physical manifestations were called abnormalities, unkillable monsters based on ideas, fairy tales, and experiences and such. The same can be said for aberrations, which are essentially alternate versions of an abnormality. As far as anyone's really concerned, they're all abnormalities at the end of the day. Now, the neat part about abnormalities is that they not only produce heavily addictive drugs, they also produce ego equipment, or extermination of geometrical organ. Yeah, I don't know what that is either. I'm assuming it's some kind of translation jank. Anyway, the important thing to note is that these are essentially powerful items that can grant special powers to those that wield them, assuming they have the fortitude to do so, as without it, it's less that they're wearing the ego and more that the ego is wearing them. So, with that out of the way, what else about Lobotomy Corporation is important? Well, they had branches all over the city, and when L Corp fell, all of their branches decided to bury themselves underground permanently. This left all of the abnormalities, ego, and employees trapped underground, doomed to play by the rules of the abnormalities until they either starved to death or became their prey. This event is known as the Dark Days and White Nights, which caused the occurrence of distortions, which was the process of a human turning into a monster, similar to an abnormality, usually caused through intense stress, such as a being on the verge of death, or by being a massive coward and running away like four times in a row. You know who you are. Anyway, this process can also cause a person to form their own ego, through sheer willpower, really, to stand up again despite the hopeless situation they're faced with. Now, whilst we know how it works, the vast majority of the city does not. Hence, distorting is a decently common occurrence, and manifesting one's ego is not. Aside from the city itself, there are also a few other locations, namely the outskirts and the ruins, with the outskirts being a wasteland that surrounds the city, and the ruins being the literal rest of the world. What led to this situation? We don't know. Yet. So, with that all squared away in your mind, Palace, let's go over associations and syndicates. Starting with syndicates, they're basically gangs. The biggest five of them are called Fingers, and together they're collectively called the Hand. These particular syndicates are literally called the Thumb, Index, Middle, Ring, and Pinky. So far, we've seen the Thumb, Index, and Ring in action, and yes, they aren't particularly good at naming themselves. There are several small ones that either align with a Finger or remain independent. Syndicates that work for Fingers often have to pay some kind of tribute, or are expected to do exactly as ordered without question. As for independent Fixers, well, there are several. However, these often lack in size compared to a Finger, and are usually contained to a single district. They are better at naming themselves, however, unlike the next group. Allow me to introduce the 12 associations. These associations are led by the top dog Hana Association. These are essentially massive divisions of Fixers, who are basically a mix of office workers and mercenaries. Now, I call them unoriginal because they are literally numbered 1 through to 12, the number of their association being written in the language their culture is based on. The Japanese one is pretty clever, but the English one is literally 7. They're the 7 Association. Anyways, if you aren't a good enough fixer for an association, there's also officers, which are essentially the equivalent of a small business owner in the mercenary world. While not as illustrious as an association, an office is usually a good place to start. Now, fixers themselves are graded from ranks 1 to 9, with 9 being the worst and 1 being the best. However, occasionally there are people who are better than the best. In cases like this, the Hana Association deems them to be a color fixer, giving them a color and dooming them to wear it for the rest of their lives. As of right now, we know of 7 color fixers, each with a variety of bullshit abilities ranging from hitting people so hard they turn to a red mist to the ability to travel between dimensions. Of course, only two are confirmed to be alive as of Limbus Company, with four confirmed dead, and one that was mentioned in passing. Oh, and of course, one happens to be your bus guide, so you know, don't get on his bad side. And that's about all you need to know. Obviously, I kept it brief for the sake of time and spoilers, but if you want more details, you can head on over to the wiki or just play the games yourself. They're a lot of fun. Also, if you're interested in any additional material such as Leviathan or Wonder Lab, I'll leave a link in the description below. However, if you want to finish Leviathan, I hope you know Korean, because it wasn't fully translated in English. Thanks, Project Moon. Anyway, that's all for now, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.